Hi everyone, welcome back to the Learn Scriptcase from Scratch course. So we're continuing part two in this video. This is the last video in part two, and we're gonna look at the database more, and this time modeling, actually building out the database structure and everything so that our applications will work. So my name is Nate Carpenter. I'm the instructor leading this. As you can see, we are in part two of this course. We got a few more parts, but we're getting close to actually starting developing in Scriptcase. So as you know, we're using Global Music Supply as a fictional case study to guide us here. We're building an inventory management system for them. So we need a backend database for this. We've installed a database system. We've looked at some different tools to help us administer the database, add users, etc. And now we need to actually start building out the database for this. So as you know, we've used MariaDB or MySQL for our database. And we've used MySQL Workbench. That's going to be our primary tool for setting up our database. We've also looked at Scriptcase's built-in tools, as well as PHP MyAdmin, which we're going to look at in this video too, so that we have all the options available to us for this. So let's look a little bit at our database structure. So as you know, we're going to have three main tables for our three main products: sheet music, recordings, and instruments. And then we're going to have three kind of subtables to support those. So genre, so that we can have different genres for sheet music and recordings. For recordings, there's going to be different types of media like CD, vinyl, MP3, etc. And for instruments, there's going to be different categories like string instruments, brass instruments, percussion instruments, etc. So that's how that is going to be set up. That's going to be the basic structure for our table. So nothing too complicated. We're going to set up some foreign key relationships to link our main tables to our subtables and so forth. So now let's go over to MySQL Workbench and get started with building out these tables. Okay, so here we are in MySQL Workbench. We set up our database in the previous video. Now if we double click that database, we are now using that, and we can go up here to create a new table. So let's go ahead and create a table here. Let's go ahead and name it. This is going to be our recordings table to store all of our recordings. And then we can add our columns right here. So that's our column name. So we need an ID first. That's going to be a unique integer value there. And if you click that drop down, you can see more. But this is going to be our primary key, and it's going to be an auto increment as well. So as you can see, there's some settings right there. And then down below, there are some settings as well. So there's going to be our ID field. You could set a length on that. And then our next one is going to be a name field. So I'm going to call it name. That's going to be a varchar. I'm going to make that a little bit longer, make that like 255. So there's plenty of space for the data to be stored in there. So that's the main parts. Now we need a ensemble field. So another varchar field. So what type of ensemble this recording is of. The name of the ensemble, I mean, or the band. Whatever you want to do. And then after ensemble, we're going to need our release year, which is going to be a release date, actually, which is going to be a date field. So let me make sure that's named correctly. So that is going to be a date. So let me pull from the drop down there and see. Let me see if I can find it here. So it's got date time, but I want just a regular date. There it is. And then we need our genre and media fields to link to our genre and media tables. So genre underscore ID. And that is going to be an int of the same type of the ID, since that needs to be linked to our genre ID field over on our genre table when we create that in a second. And then media underscore ID, same type of thing, going to be a foreign key that links to our media table here in a second. So there are those two tables, just two fields, I mean. And then we also need a quantity field, which is going to be another integer, so that we know how many is in stock for this recording. So there we go. There's all our fields set up, and we can go ahead and click apply on all those. So there's some different settings down there. But for now, we're just going to click apply. There's the SQL for that, which looks good. Go ahead and click apply on that. And everything was executed successfully, so that's great. So now our recordings table set up. Now let's go ahead and create our genre table to support that. And then once that is done, you should know pretty much everything you need to do this. So we'll just skip ahead. And you can create these on your own if you want, and I'll create them off recording. So we're going to create a new table. Table name is genre, ID. It's going to be our primary key, and also going to be an auto increment here. And then the genre name, and that's going to be a varchar as well of 255. Keep it consistent throughout our system for our name fields. And then let me make sure that name column name is correct there. And then I can go ahead and apply those changes to create that table. So go ahead and click apply. There is our SQL, and it looks like there's an error there. Let me make sure that there wasn't something wrong with this. So we click cancel on this. We go back and yes, that needs to be a primary key. I forgot to do that. And it needs to be auto increment and everything. So I forgot that setting. There we go. Now that looks good. Let's go ahead and click apply. Everything was applied successfully. Go ahead and click finish, and we are good to go. So now we can link those together. So if we go back to the recordings table here, and there is our data. So there's no data there, but if we just click on the name of that, we can get the structure again. So let me go back there, and there's our structure. And we need to link that genre ID over there to our genre table ID right there. So let me go ahead and create the foreign key there. So you go to foreign key down at the bottom. You can name it what you want and then name the reference table as well. So it's going to link to that recordings table, and the column is going to be over here. So let me go ahead and name this foreign key something. Let me make sure I get in the correct field there. So recordings is going to be our target table. Let me make sure I name it correctly here. So let's see, what should I name this? Let's name this genre like so, and then the referenced table over here. So you can link it to the column over there on this table. So the reference table is going to be recordings, right, like so. And so the ID is going to link over there to the ID. Let me choose the correct table, sorry about that. And the ID is going to link over there to that ID and the genre ID. So we can do that for the rest of our tables there in MySQL Workbench. For now, let's go over the PHP MyAdmin and see some of the features over there that we can use for this. Okay, so here we are in PHP MyAdmin. You can install this on your server, and we've got that database all set up, and actually everything is created in here. But let's just look at what we can do here. So we can click new here to add a new table. It's just like MySQL Workbench, name the table, create the fields, etc. We go over here to operations to copy some things, rename some things, etc. We could go to export here, just like in MySQL Workbench. If we wanted to export our table, we could use a template. We could do a quick or custom one, depending if we wanted to everything or just some of it. And then our format's SQL, and click go, and it would export our whole table. And if we go to import, then we can import a backup to or copy from another one, just choosing that SQL file here in PHP MyAdmin. So that's how you can use PHP MyAdmin. Let's go over the Scriptcase and look at some of the tools there for creating tables and structures in Scriptcase. Okay, so we're in our Scriptcase development environment, and I'm going to go to the database menu up here at the top. And we've got some options for importing some data, but we're going to set up our tables first. So first, we're going to go to Database Builder here so we can set up our tables. So as I said, I've got some of this already configured. So I click on that and choose my connection. That's our inventory connection that we set up last time. And as you can see, I have some tables already set up. And we can click on those and see some of the structures with those. So if I click on Recordings here, you can see the fields. I've got an ID, which is auto increment, that's our primary key, the name, ensemble, release date, genre ID, which is going to be linked to our genre table, and our media ID, two, which is going to be linked to our media table right there, as you can see. And then I've got a quantity field to keep track of how many is on there. So now let's create a table. So click create table. And this is going to be for instruments. So I'm going to name this table instruments, make sure I spell it correctly here. And then we can add some fields. So this is going to be pretty simple. I'm going to add an ID field first, and that's going to be an int of length 10, like so. And then a name, which is going to be a varchar of length 255. So select varchar 255. So as you can see, this is a pretty simple way to set up a database. This is kind of like some other products that you might see, but now we can do it right inside of Scriptcase. So category, that's going to be an int of 10, and that's going to be category ID actually. That's going to be linked to our category table, which we're going to create next. Okay, so int of 10, like so. And then our quantity here is going to be an int as well of 10, like so. So we can keep track of how many of that is on there. And then ID is going to be auto increment as well. So let's go ahead and hit save on that. And that table should be all created and ready to go. So as you can see, we've got all those fields set up. Now let's create our category table as well to link it to that category ID field. So click create table again. This is going to be a category. And this field, this table is going to be very, very simple. It's just two fields, an ID and a name. So an ID is going to be unique. That's going to be an int of 10. That's going to be our primary key. And then our name is going to be a varchar of 255, just like all the other names in this database. So 255, that'll give us a nice big field for us to add there. Make the ID auto increment so that it is primary. And then we've got some options there, just like you would see in any database structure. Click save on this. And now we can add a foreign key to this. So we can link that ID to the ID, the category ID on instruments. So let's go over to the instruments table there and add a foreign key to it. So click add foreign key here. And we need to choose our category table, just like so. And our source is going to be the category ID on that. And the target is going to be the ID on our instrument, on our category field there. So as you can see, we can do some different actions on a delete so that it doesn't allow deleting data that we don't want to. So we can make sure we maintain good data there without any missing references or anything. So there we go. Our tables are all set up for our database like so. So there's another tool that we can use to administer our database, and that is the SQL Builder. So if I go back to databases here and choose SQL Builder, I can build queries to select data from our databases. So as you can see, I have a list of all the tables in my database right here, and I can choose recordings here and click confirm, and then go on to fields, and I can select which fields I want to see. So I'm going to do ID and name, like so, click confirm on that. And then I can go to the next tab here, condition. So if I click that, I can choose some conditions. So I can choose a field to set a condition on. So perhaps name or name equals something like test. And I don't have any data in this database yet, so we're not going to see anything. But as you can see, that's going to add a where clause in it. I can order it by a certain field. So I can order it by ID, ascending or descending. Click confirm on that. And then the next tab is going to allow me to run the query right here. So here's the query. You can see it. And as you can see, it added the where in the order by clauses there. And click run. And it would return any data here below. I don't have any data in this table yet, but it would have it right there below. And then I can save this query as well. So that's just a really easy way to build a select statement without having to code it all out by hand. Very simple, very easy to use. So it's a very useful tool that Scriptcase provides us with our SQL Builder.